One of the easiest ways to make your website stand out is by adding custom fonts. And in this video tutorial, I'm going to show you how to add custom fonts to the free version of Elementor along with the pro version of Elementor. So let's jump right into it. Okay, so let's just talk a little bit about custom fonts and the way WordPress works so that you can get an understanding, because there's lots of different variables in different situations. Wow, I am so rude. I'm actually filming this after I filmed the video, and I just remembered I totally forgot to introduce myself. Hi, my name is Adam from WPCrafter.com, where I make WordPress tutorial videos for non-techies. If you are new here, consider clicking on the subscribe button. If you don't want to miss a thing, click on the bell. YouTube will let you know when I have a new video. Anything that I talk about will be linked in the video description box now down below. Now back to our regularly scheduled programming. So when we're talking about using custom fonts, there's two things we're talking about. We have a theme on your WordPress website, and then you have your page builder, in this case, Elementor. So we're going to be talking about both of these and making the distinguishing between adding custom fonts to a theme and adding it to a page builder. And then there's two types of custom fonts. You have your traditional custom fonts, where there's different websites that provide custom fonts. You could purchase custom fonts, you download and want to use those, where they're actually uploaded to your website. And then there's something else called Typekit fonts. Typekit is a service that provides fonts as a service. So those are the two different things there. And next thing is, we have two different versions of Elementor. We have Elementor, which is the free version. You can download this for free and use it, and many people are. In fact, 500,000 people are. And then there's the pro version, which is an add-on to Elementor. So let's look at the best options for all these various scenarios and then go through how to do them. Okay, so the three things that I'm going to be talking about is custom fonts. This is a free plugin. Custom Typekit fonts, it's also a free plugin, and also the newly launched Elementor Pro, which has custom fonts built into it. So let me try to guide you to the best path to have custom fonts and then show you how to do it. So here's a free plugin called Custom Fonts. Now, what this plugin does is it gives you an interface of adding custom fonts, and it will work with Elementor, the free version, and the paid version as well. It will also work with the Astra theme. So this plugin is ideal for anyone that is using the free version of Elementor. So if you're using the free version of Elementor and you want custom fonts, this plugin's gonna make it easy for you. Now, there's also, if you're an Astra theme user, it's even better, because you could load those custom fonts in one location and they're gonna be available to your theme and also available in Elementor. What's really nice about this method is if you ever changed themes, your custom fonts will still be loaded and still work within the free version of Elementor. Now, the same goes for custom Typekit fonts. This plugin right here, it's the same thing, except this is for Typekit. It'll work in the free version of Elementor, the Elementor Pro, of course, as well. And it also has that added benefit. If you're an Astra theme user, it will also carry over into the WordPress theme. Now, just launched is Elementor Pro, a new update that has custom fonts, but it's only for Elementor Pro. So it's, you know, up to you if you have Elementor Pro and you're not using the Astra theme, which way you want to go, whether you want to just use the plugin custom fonts or you want to use what Elementor Pro offers you. One of the things I like about this blog post here from Elementor Pro about them launching the feature is they have a list of some best practices right here. Bring your fonts into Elementor. And so these best practices are going to carry on over into the custom fonts plugin and the Elementor Pro's way of adding custom fonts to Elementor. Now, I'm going to come right back to this, but here is a WordPress install here. I believe I already installed the plugin. Let me just double check. Okay, so in this theme, I do happen to have Elementor installed. I have Elementor Pro here, but not activated yet. I've already installed the custom fonts plugin. And let's just verify I am using the Astra theme. So now if you're going to go about this way and you have Elementor free and you want to have custom fonts, this is the way you're going to do it. So once you activate the custom fonts plugin, you're going to see an option underneath appearance that says custom fonts. I've already gone ahead and added one, but let me go ahead and delete that and we'll do it together. So with the way that Elementor Pro has it, and I'm going to show you that in a moment, and also the way that custom fonts does it, this free plugin, when you go to add a custom font, you give it a name, and you could name this whatever you want. And then there's these options here of the file to upload. Now we have WOFF2, WOFF, TTF, EOT, SVG. Now, when you look at this, it could be like, oh my gosh, this is a little on the overwhelming side. I don't even know what to do. Now, let's jump back to that Elementor Pro blog post. They actually got this from W3 Schools, this website right here. So here are what these different font format types are. So there's the web open font format. And it gives you an explanation of why you'd want to use this and why you'd want to use this. And you would load up all of these, or not all of these, as many of them as you can. So essentially what you're going to want to do is have this WOFF2 font type that you're adding. Okay. And it says right here, true type open type font that provides better compression than WOFF1. So this right here is the most recommended format. However, this second version of it, the font file is going to actually be smaller. And so that's why version 2 is ideal. And I think right here in the custom fonts plugin, that's probably why you see it listed here at the top. These would be in order of priority, I suppose. So that is that. And then the TTF, it says this font was developed in the late 80s by Apple and Microsoft. So that's okay. The reason why there's these different font formats is because there's so many different web browsers out there. It's not just Chrome, Safari, Firefox, and Opera. You've got an Internet Explorer. You've got like multiple years of these different versions of each of these different web browsers. And so that's why you have this. Okay. And then right here, this is actually important. This EOT format, embedded open type fonts. And it says this font file works with Internet Explorer, but not on other browsers. Make sure you use this format to support earlier versions of IE. So what happens is you would ideally add this WOFF version and the EOT version so you have maximum coverage. So when someone visits your website, it will serve up the EOT if they're on an old version of Internet Explorer. Okay, so that's why you have these different font types. Okay, so now let me show you how to go ahead and add it here. So first we'll just give it a name. And for me, I'll just go ahead and fill out a name right now. There it is, Bibas or Babas or whatever the name of this font is. And I'm going to upload a TTF font. Now here's the little nuance here. When you click on upload, normally you might click on upload files and then click on select files and navigate on your files on your computer to find it. But WordPress only wants certain file types and it won't let you upload it. So you're going to have to just drag and drop it right in there. So I'm dragging and dropping it in and then it will accept it that way. So if you try to do select file, it's not going to work. I'll actually also test that in the Elementor Pro version. So we will click on select and there it is. Now all I need to, if I had the other formats, I would add it. I just don't right now. And that's because I was using this font for some graphic design. Anyways, I'll click on add new font. And there it is. I have my new font. Now all I need to do is go into an Elementor page. And let's see, I will go ahead and let's just choose this contact us page. I'll click on edit with Elementor. And we're going to see, so here's my headline. If I click on it, I can go to style, and then here's my typography. I can go right here, and for font family, I can go like this, and it's just easier to start typing it in. Now, it's probably pulling the name from what I put the name as when I created the custom font. So let's just try typing that in. There it is. B-E-B-A-S, and it's listed right there as a system font. And when I click on it, you can see it switched to the font right there for me. That was really simple. It's very simple, and I love this way of doing it. I love this custom fonts plugin. Now, let me give you one little caveat with it. This was a brand new update to the plugin to add this direct page builder integration. I've already opened up a support ticket on this, but if you click right here and try to set the default fonts that Elementor is going to use, and you go to primary headline and you do a search for it, you'll see it's not finding it. I think this might just be a minor oversight with the plugin, and I'm sure that I've already reported it that they'll get an update out. So by the time you're watching this video, it will probably work here and you'll be able to set it as these defaults right there. So that is the custom fonts plugin. It is fantastic. Here, let me leave here. Now, also you have the added benefit if you're an Astra theme user. It's a free theme. They have a pro version. It's only $59. You can visit WPCrafter.com/Astra if you wanted to check that out. But it's also going to be available in the customizer. So let me just show you this. Now, the benefit here is you only have to load your fonts in one location to have it available in your theme and in your page builder. To date, there's no other solution for this. But of course, you have to be using the Astra theme. So if I'm in here, I can click on typography, and I can click on base typography. And for headings, it's set to Playfair, but I could scroll up to the top, and there it is. If I scroll up to the top, it says it right here, and it's gonna instead use this font family for my headings. Okay, and that's all that you have to do there. Let me do a publish, and then let me exit out of here. So that is using the custom fonts way of doing it, and it's pretty much the same method using the custom fonts Typekit fonts plugin right here. Okay, so now let's go ahead and activate Elementor Pro and take a quick look at that. It's pretty much very similar. And they also have a tutorial on the Elementor Pro website. I'm going to just go ahead and activate it. I'm not going to take the time to pop the license in. But what happens is underneath your Elementor menu, you now have a new option that says custom fonts. And here it is. We would just click on add new. And I'll go ahead and enter the title or the name of the family. There it is. And I'll add a font variation. And I really like, obviously, this interface is really slick. So, and I like how right here where it's the spot for me to add the font, it's giving me that little bit of information so I know what I'm doing. So before I was referring to here, I could go here and now I know why I want to have these different versions. So I'm going to go ahead and let's see. Here it is, the Bebas or Bebas or whatever. Go and I'm going to add that. And then there it is. It is added. And I need to choose a weight and a style. So it's not pulling this information directly from the font. I actually have to tell it what it is. And so on this case, I think that's a thick font right here. So this is just kind of left up to your judgment right here. This is because in Elementor Pro, they're allowing you to put in each font in a font family. So if I had, say, this is a font family and there's five different fonts, there's an italic one, a really thick weighted one, and a really thin one, a light one, I can add each of those to the family. So I'll go ahead and click on publish. And there it is. It actually looks like it's given me a brief little snapshot of what it's going to look like. That's wonderful. And then I can keep adding my font variations just like that. And so let me click on update. And I have never actually done this. I'm doing this all off the cuff. So let's go ahead and hop in a page and see what that's like. So let me go back into that contact page. I'm going to click on edit or contact us page. And we should see it there. Okay, so, all right, so let's go right here, go on style, go on typography, and here's our fonts right here. And let me go ahead and enter it in. We should probably see two entries for it. And we actually only see one entry. That's probably because the method that Custom Fonts is using to add it is the same method as Elementor is. But this would be interesting if I go back here to the default fonts, if now we're able to see it because we're doing it the, yep, there it is, Custom Fonts. See, we're doing it now the Elementor Pro way, which brings it into here. So anyways, I just wanted to show you two different ways that you can, or several, I showed you more than two ways, the best ways of adding custom fonts to Elementor. And remember, if you're using the free version of Elementor, you could still use these custom fonts, and it doesn't matter what theme you're using. If you're using Astra, though, and Elementor, you only have to add it to one place, which is a huge benefit. Hey, if you don't have Astra or Elementor, you could visit WPCrafter.com/Elementor or WPCrafter.com/Astra. Those will actually take you to a page on my website where I have some additional training for those products, and I've got the information there for you on that. Hey, I wanted to ask you, what are some of the resources on the internet that you're aware of for downloading free fonts, or what kind of font combinations for custom fonts have you found that are really good? Which ones that go really good together? So it'd be great to hear from you in the comment section down below some of the places that you've come across for custom fonts. I want to know, and I'm sure anyone watching this video would want to know as well. Hey, thanks for watching this video and all the support you give me. I will see you in the next video.